Yo, this is going to be a great video today, breaking down whether Football Manager is, I've had enough. I've had enough of this stupid wooden chair. Ugh. Much better. I mean, just check out that ergonomic design. That backsport. Those weird gamer chair lines. Seriously, thank you so much to M. Chester for sending me a new chair. In celebration, we will be leaving my old wooden creaky chair in the background to be mocked for the rest of the stream. Stream, this is a video. This is a YouTube video, and it's an important one. This is a video that I put off as long as I possibly can until I have to make it. It's a video where I decide whether to recommend buying Football Manager 21 if you own Football Manager 20 already. I will walk you through whether it's worth buying it if you own older football managers as well. That's generally the point of this video, and it's one that I look forward to doing every year into the future. And we are going to talk about the things that are good in Football Manager 21, the improvements, and we're also going to talk about the things that are bad in Football Manager 21. And there are things that are bad in Football Manager 21, not just in creative direction, but in execution. And at the end, we will weigh whether that means it's worth buying Football Manager or not this year. So as you might have heard if you watch this channel, I stream on Twitch, and the link is down in the description if you want to join me. And on those Twitch streams, we play a ton of Football Manager at times. Part of that has been an experience in learning about whether Football Manager 21 is a significant improvement or not. And you've heard me perhaps on stream talk about how Football Manager 21 is a really dramatic improvement in the match engine. But talking about problems that the game has, we're actually going to start with the match engine, because there is a really significant problem with the match engine, and it has to do with fast breaks. And it's something that has driven me crazy, that's clearly hard-coded into the game as having supremacy over other things that might logically make more sense. And that is that defensive players are more wedded to their specific position than they are wedded to defending the play and stopping the ball. So for an example, we're gonna go into a match that my Oriental Dragons side, which is a real club that we've taken over in Portugal, won against Lusitana Evora 4-3. We start with a corner from our boy Chico Shen. He's taking a nice corner, and the ball is headed out nice and clean, and it falls rather kindly for Quitumbo. There's nothing weird in the match engine yet, and as Quitumbo gets into his approach, it's pretty clear he's going to be dealing with two defenders in front of him. We have the one attacker, Gonzalez. We have Ty Turner, who's my right back, and then we have Marlon Costa, who's not covered himself in glory with his initial positioning. He's given up the channel onto Quitumbo's strong foot, but that's just him being bad. That's not really the match engine. So then where does the issue come in from here? Well, the issue is what Ty Turner is going to do in this situation, because as Quitumbo gets into this space, Ty Turner continues to defend the guy next to him, which would be the logical thing to do considering he's the player I left back on set pieces, him and Marlon Costa. So they're both back there to try and slow this down. Marlon is just not doing particularly well, which good for him. But he's not normally a starting player anyways. Ty Turner is, though, on the other hand. And as he gets into this position, Quitumbo is going to start to load up for a shot. And as Quitumbo starts to load up for a shot, he's loading up for a pass here, we see Ty Turner running away. My right back is actively running away from the only offensive threat anywhere near this because he's the right back. And here's where the issue comes in on these counterattacks, on these fast break moves. Right backs and left backs are still married to their position more so than they're married to the logical defensive play. So as Ivan Diaz starts to work his way in to the sphere, Ty Turner is leaving. As the ball is played, you see Ty Turner realize as the ball enters Gonzalez's sphere in the match engine that, oh shoot, he probably shouldn't have left, and he starts running back, which means that the code in the game wasn't telling him to go defend these guys, or if it was, it clearly wasn't valuing the threat Gonzalez posed high enough as he was the immediate threat. Gonzalez is going to take one touch, and he actually ends up scoring, which sucked. We ended up winning the game 4-3. Thank goodness. But that is obviously a huge issue inside the match engine when your right and left backs are abandoning their position in the middle of a counterattack because they believe it is time to go to their flank position when it's just not. I mean, it's just not. And outside of the issue in the match engine, there are some other issues with Football Manager 21. The main one outside of the match engine is that the biggest overhaul that occurred is actually in the press relations, the relationship with the press. Now, I've started up a flirtationship with one of the journalists, Vanessa, because she was the only journalist that followed my club for a while until we got promoted to the same division. It's rather complicated. Hi, Vanessa. But there are a lot of people that just skip press conferences. And you can make the argument that the improvement in the press conferences means they're not going to skip them. But the questions are still fairly repetitive, and as somebody that plays the game a lot, I am able to rapidly click through the responses without having to get close to reading all of them. And they do not have major effects on anything that happens in the game, despite some minor effects on player morale and opinions, view, and coach support and that sort of thing, depending on what you say about particular players. But a huge overhaul in interaction is not something that in itself is worth buying the game for. So even though it might have been necessary to do that, you would have liked to have seen them make some other improvements outside of that in terms of the play of the game. Because Football Manager 21, if you've played Football Manager 20, is going to feel very similar. There is no new section and no large change to things like scouting or training or dynamics. Part of the interaction makes its way into the dynamics. You can have quick chats with players. They've used gestures to replace the tone of your voice, which makes sense, but still feels basically the same as the tone of your voice would before. They just transpose the name of the system. And so a big issue with Football Manager 21 is, in large part, I would assume, benefit of the doubt to SI and Football Manager in general, is that is because, well, there's a pandemic going on, the game is a little harder to make. And that's what makes the good things about Football Manager perhaps that much more surprising, because there are some good things inside the match engine and outside of the match engine that are big improvements and very important and very, I don't know if satisfying is the right word, but heartening that those changes were made, even if it seems a little listless in terms of large overhauls in basically the grand strategy of the game. There's a lot of overhauls that make the game feel a lot better. And there are two huge improvements in Football Manager. And the first one is around finishing and goalkeeper reaction with finishing. So the improvements to decision making and spatial awareness means there's a lot more opportunity for players to improve their finishing. And that means a wider variety of finishing. Goalkeepers now go to the ground in 1v1 situations and move more intelligently because they also are using spatial awareness that is now coded into the game. And it should solve what has long been a point of pain, that 1v1s between strikers and goalkeepers, at least angled 1v1s, seem to end one of two ways. The ball is blasted in a straight line into the back of the net, or the ball is blasted in a straight line right into the hands of the keeper with a frustrating lack of variety. So let's take a look at that first good thing, which is the ability to finish, the ability of the goalkeepers, so on and so forth. And these 1v1 situations all due to new spatial awareness, new animations, new things coded into the game. So we have Brash. He's just taken the ball off of one of the defenders. He collects the ball, plays a sparkling through ball to Eric Mendez. At this point, when Mendez picks up the ball, nothing is new from Football Manager 20 to Football Manager 21. Everything that happens afterward is going to be fairly new, because what we're going to see is Eric Mendez slow down, take stock with that decision making and spatial awareness, and then apply his attributes to find a finish that nobody in any other Football Manager would be able to find. And the variety of finishes that are available in Football Manager 21 are dramatically higher, because that typical blasted at the goalkeeper, blasted into the back of the net, has so much more variety in terms of finesse, a much wider variety of angles for the blasting, a lot more decisions that can be made depending on how good or bad the player is in these isolation situations. And of course, the goalkeeper can now also go to the ground, as we're going to see here. So Eric Mendez takes his first touch, he's going to take another touch, and then he's going to slow things down. The goalkeeper is going to try and come out off his line and go after Eric Mendez, who then hits him with the little bit of sauce and pops it over the top for, quite honestly, one of my favorite goals that's been scored this season. And this is not something that is entirely unlikely in Football Manager. We'll go watch at full speed. This is not something that's unlikely in Football Manager. It happens a lot, not just the chipped finish, but a huge variety of finishes, players slowing down, realizing how much space they have, goalkeepers doing everything they can from a wide bag of tricks to try and stop them, and goals of imminent sauce. being scored by beasts like Eric Mendez, who's still better than Ronaldo. And the finishing is not the only huge improvement the match engine has had. There's another one, and that is the fact that midfield play is no longer nerfed. The ball in Football Manager 20 in particular was not allowed to go into the midfield nearly as often as it should, which led to overpowered wing play because the midfield couldn't be handled by the AI defense. They hadn't figured out how to write a script that could handle an unnerfed midfield. Now they have a script that can handle an unnerfed midfield, so you get much more natural looking plays. Like, well, this one that I'm going to show you, but is painful. It's a goal against me in a match we ended up losing 2-1, one of our four losses all season, and probably because this pass is sauce. Now, not a lot of people are playing with attacking midfielders in Portugal for whatever reason. I'm not playing one. I'm playing a very direct style, so I'm not seeing as many of these nice through balls and focused play through the middle. We're just hoofing it long. But this is a fantastic example of the types of through balls and the wide variety of skilled passes and through balls that we're seeing come through the middle of the park, not only to create chances, but to open up play now that emphasis is in the middle of the park. The ball is going to be knocked around a couple of times to open up space. Jose Ricardo is going to take a touch and then drop a pass that, quite honestly, in any other Football Manager just wouldn't be hit. He's going to slip two lines and drop a ball to Betinho. And this is in the third division of Portugal. So if the people here can do it, then there's certainly a bunch of better players that you'll probably be managing that will also be able to do it. Now, these are the type of passes that Football Manager has just not been able to have before. And right when you start playing Football Manager 21, you will feel a difference in the variety of finishes. You will feel a difference in the variety of play moving forward. And the thing that adds to that variety, and something that it's hard to show a concrete example of, but I do have one for you, that is the variety in movement. So because of the decision-making and the spatial awareness and those sorts of things that are now in Football Manager 21, you see a wide variety of movement from players that typically were a little more wedded to their positions, whether they're dropping in to receive the ball as forwards or whether they're exploiting an obvious space to go forward as a midfielder. That's what I'm about to show you. My backup center midfielder, who is playing a center midfield support role, is about to take advantage of a bunch of space that all of a sudden pops up in front of him. We see my striker Guilherme take a touch, and Guilherme is a striker, an advanced forward who has dropped in close to the midway line to receive the ball. All of a sudden, Gonzalo Silva's taken off. He is a left-sided center midfielder on support, and he is now branched over. You see him consciously make this decision in the match engine to head for this space, because all of a sudden they're marked up on this side. There's nobody that's going to be responsible for this space, because this guy's just being an idiot and marking Marlon Costa, who he's expecting to be the runner in this situation, now that the normal person he's defending, Guilherme, is gone. So that movement from Gonzalo Silva allows him to find a space. He slips into that space and is able to score a beautiful goal for Oriental Dragon, his first goal for the club, actually. So this guy is nowhere near a stud, but he still is able to make the logical decision, see the space, and fill the space while getting into the attack. And I obviously had attacking mentality on, which helps them look for that sort of thing. But that is a center mid on support leading the line because the opportunity presented itself. That fluidity of movement is another huge plus. And that, of course, is just in the match engine. While I will typically knock what Football Manager 21 has to offer outside of the match engine with the minor interaction tweaks, there is one other bonus that is fantastic. That's the recruitment meeting. The recruitment meeting is something I wasn't sure about when we were learning about features, but it's something that I actually really love and apply. Because your scouts come to you with 3, 4, 5 positions of interest that you might want to fill in the coming transfer window. They'll also meet with a week left in the transfer window to go over anything that you might need before the window is done. And they will present you with reasonable signings for that position. Now, at my position, that's just basically people on end of contracts, potential loans, and free signings. So I just get a nice palette of players that's represented, shown to me by my general manager and by my director, or the owner is in the meeting, the chief scout is in the meeting, and they show you a list of 3 to 8 players that might meet your need at that position. Not might, they think will meet your need at that position. You can trial them, loan them, you can scout them out of that position, and they recommend that you create a scouting role for that as well, which there's now a meme in the FM community that you always turn that down, but it's nice. It keeps you focused, it's a more realistic approach to scouting, and that you sit down and you say, here are some players we think can improve the team, look at them, what do you think? And it's helped me make a few signings, quite honestly, in my Twitch save. And those are the major bonuses that I think Football Manager 21 really brings to the game. There's a lot of things that didn't change, and that's obviously what falls into the detractor section as well, all the way down to the set piece mechanics really haven't changed. Now, obviously, the match engine changes the way set pieces feel a little bit, but in terms of what you can do for them, they haven't exactly changed. And a lot of aspects of the game haven't really been touched. The overall strategy of the game hasn't really been touched. But it's time for me to render my final decision. Now that we've had the game out for, well, more than a month, if you include the beta, a final decision about whether Football Manager 21 is worth buying. I pray for strength in making this decision. I pray for guidance. It is. Football Manager 21 is worth buying, and it's the match engine alone. The improvements to the match engine, as I speculated based off the inside scoops I was able to get right before the game came out, is fantastic. It's amazing that Nick Madden and his team under Miles were able to figure out how to improve the match engine this much from year to year. I really wish they'd been able to add something outside of the game, but from FM20 to FM21, especially with the amount of time we'll have to play it with an ongoing global pandemic, it is absolutely worth the buy. It feels like a completely different game because, let's be honest, the game is what happens on the field. Every single thing you're doing outside of it, the grand strategy of Football Manager is to set yourself up to succeed on the field. And watching someone dink a saucy little chip shot around the keeper, or bend the ball in the bottom corner of your keeper, come sliding in to make a fantastic save, or get down and bat it away with the left hand, or your brilliant attacking midfielder actually dropping dimes of through balls and opening up play and drifting around. Watching all of that happen is just so incredibly rewarding that it is worth it. And then, so obviously, from Football Manager 19 on down, I believe very worth it to upgrade. Even if you don't value the match engine changes, the changes from FM19 to FM20 were definitely significant enough that I believe an upgrade is due. Now, I am not in cahoots and don't work with Football Manager or SI at all, so I do have the ability to relate to you exactly what I feel. And if you ask me on stream, you ask me on the street, that's how I feel. Football Manager 21 is worth it. It's certainly far from perfect, but it is worth it. And I thank them for the effort during a pandemic. I will see you guys in another video. Keep it beautiful.